This one's pretty interesting because this clip, courtesy again the fact that I can subreddit, is highlights or is proof that maybe the money thing, the lack of income or something, the money issues they're having over there and the fire and the kid and Thick Boy is somewhat true. And the reason why I'm saying this is because I've said previously on this show, I don't understand why Brendan does the Schaub show so early in the morning, because he clearly isn't a morning person. He comes to the show really, I don't know, hungover, tired, whatever it may be, not in the best kind of, you know, energy levels to kind of get the show done in a really good, fun and interactive way. And I think even if you're going to do it on the way back home, you know, after the school run, why not just wait a couple more hours and do it after lunch or something? He doesn't. But then I think the one that suffers the most off the show, the one element, is the ad reads, because he's already, you know, struggles with the English language anyway. And then when he's having to do these shows early in the morning, not being a morning person, and having to do these ad reads, he sounds fucking terrible. And I've always wondered, why doesn't he just pre-record the ad reads? Why aren't they just done like other pods where you just record a whole run of ad reads and then you just kind of insert them to your video? Like, why not just do that? But I guess that requires effort, that requires planning and shit, and he just goes. So clearly, I think this is a sign that money is low, because he would never have done this where he kind of has clearly pre-recorded these ad reads and then inserted them into the show, because they've got the banner, the ticket thing, like everything's been done a certain way. And I think there's even a change in clothing, I'm sure, somewhere along here. Like, it's a show to me that they're making an effort now because the ads aren't as plentiful. Because I think in the past, Brendan would have just fumbled his way for an ad read, said the bare minimum, did it horribly, you know, and then if the brand or the advertiser decides to drop them, it doesn't matter. He's got 10 more ads coming. So it doesn't fucking make a dent, as fucking Chris D'Elia would say. But this is a sign to me that times are rough and they have to now acquiesce and bend to demands of the advertisers because they need them.
$150 in bonus bets instantly for betting just $5 on any fight you see Saturday night. Download the DraftKings Sportsbook app. Use the code SHAUB SHOW, S-C-H-A-U-B SHOW. That's code SHAUB SHOW, only at DraftKings Sportsbook. Gambling problem? Call 1-800-GAMBLER. New York, call 877-8-HOPE-NY or text HOPE-NY. That's 467-369. In West Virginia, visit www.1800gambler.net in partnership with Hollywood Casino at Charlestown Races. All games regulated by the West Virginia Lottery. Please play responsibly. In Connecticut, help is available for problem gambling. Call 888-789-7777 or visit ccpg.org. On behalf of Boot Hill Casino Resort, Kansas, 21 or older in most eligible states, but age varies by jurisdiction. See DraftKings.com sportsbook for details and state-specific responsible gambling resources. Bonus bets expire 7 days after issuance. Eligibility and deposit restrictions apply. Terms at sportsbook.draftkings.com/baseballterms.
Well done to Brendan. Well done to fucking Brendan. That was a difficult to get through. He was struggling, but he got through it. Pre-recorded, took his time, read through the entire fucking ad read, no fucking crazy fumbles of pronunciation, and did it well. A bit of effort, because now he has to make the effort because there's not enough ads coming in. He has to kind of hold on to the one he has. So this is, again, is proof to me a lot of this guy's issues is just more so the arrogance of not wanting to put in any effort, not wanting to put any work, because you're a big enough star to do what the fuck you want. When he puts in a bit of effort, he pre-records the fucking ad reads, he gets through them in a fucking breeze. No issue. Why can't you just do that from before? Absolutely heinous. He clearly can do it. They clearly can do it as a team. And now they're fucking doing it. Crazy. So anyway, congrats to Brendan. Well done to him. He fucking did it. He made it. He's now reading the ad reads, you know, one way through. No skips, no jumps. Fucking amazing. Exactly. Yeah, he almost said jurisdiction. Big word. Oh, mate. Honestly, big up to fucking Brendan, man. That was actually good to see. Actually somewhat encouraging. You know? You can do it too. You can do it too, people out there. You can do it too. You can do it too. Big up, Stinger Goo. Appreciate you, brother.
How much money do you think Papa makes of views?
It depends. So I think Brendan's main issue, it's not really the money he makes, it's more so the outgoing. Because I think anybody with his channel, with the views he gets, you still would live a decent life. But I feel like his outgoings kill him because it's all like a fake it till you make it. So he wants his big studio. The rent on that is fucking crazy. The salaries to Chin, the salary to to George, the other kid, the salaries to the other camera guys. It's just a lot of expenses coming out. So maybe his channel, let's say, I think his channel probably makes, AdSense alone, I think his channel could make anywhere between 6 to 10,000 a month. I think so. Let's see what it says on actually Social Blade. That's my thinking. Let's see what it says on Social Blade. Let's get it back on the screen here. Let's see what they say. But I think he makes anywhere between 6 to 10 grand a month. Let's see the fighter and the kid. Social Blade. I think it's 10, because this is not really accurate, but it gives you a rough summary of what somebody could potentially make with the amount of views they get, the size of the channel. Let's see what they say monthly. Yeah, see? Monthly, they say anywhere between 381 to 6 grand. So I think they make, on a good month, they make 10 grand. On a bad month, they probably make under 5, let's say. Let's say they make between 4 to 10,000 a month. That's what I think they probably make, right? But unfortunately, it's not a lot of money because the studio they hire is way too much for what they do, right? He hired it because he's going to have all these channels on there, BGL show, Chappelle show, but now it's just firing the kid and what? Calabasas Fight Club and his show. But you don't need that big of a studio to have all those things. You can have a small enough studio and rotate things around and still do those free shows. So the rent on that studio is crazy. You pay Callan a percentage or a split, however you split that. You have to pay Chin's salary, the George salary, all the other guys. A lot of expenses coming out on a fucking monthly basis, which probably explains why Jay Schaub was actually on the last Calabasas Fight Club, Fight Companion with Bradley Martin and the other guy, the other new kid. That's why probably, his brother was on there giving people the drinks and serving the pizzas and shit because he couldn't afford to have somebody there, you know, else to kind of work with him. So that's the issue he has. Not so much the amount of money, but the expenses because he wants to look like a big shot. So yeah, that's probably why he has to do so many fucking shows, and whatever else it may be, and maybe some money from mummy and daddy. Yeah, exactly. Oh, Young and Old Vibes. Plus as well that I'm learning that too from doing this stream because I'm not really too familiar with, the retail market. Sorry, the cost of living in America. But obviously a lot of you guys here are from there. And Young and Old Vibes saying here, 10K a month doesn't go far in LA. I've learned that from just you guys doing that whole Chin house tour thing, looking at the rent prices on some places. Like LA is crazy. Like the cost of living there is insane. So just imagine what they're paying on that mansion. I'm not sure if he bought that mansion outright in LA. They've got a mansion they live in, the cars they have, the fact that Brendan's wife is a stay-at-home mum and she's got very expensive taste, right? She's not like a mum that buys her stuff from fucking Lululemon and shit. She wants Birkins. She wants Lamborghini trucks and stuff. She wants like Hermes sandals. Like she doesn't play games. So that's a lot of money. The kids go to private school. It's fucking crazy. It's crazy. So that's the issue he has. I think anybody else would be happy with this, more than happy. But if you've got the kind of lifestyle that he has and you want to look like a big dog, 10K a month isn't enough, really. You need to make more. And the channel's even making less now than before. So imagine at their peak. When Chris Aaliyah was on there, Will Sasso, Theo Vaughn, imagine how much they were making back then when the ads were plentiful and they had loads of AdSense coming in. They must have been making like 50 grand a month sometimes. Plus on top of the tours they were doing, they must have been easily maybe clearing 100,000 a month. I could easily see that. They might have been clearing 100,000 a month at the top of their game. You know, they probably thought they were untouchable. And then a couple of women come out, accuse them of rape. Right? A couple of diddling allegations. And then suddenly the whole shit comes crumbling down. It couldn't happen to some bigger pieces of shit. I'm not going to lie. Anyway, what are you guys saying in the chat? 10K a month doesn't go far in LA. People keep saying this. 4K a month has to be allocated to the Mexicans' bag collection. Exactly, Yoshi. Another 3K goes to new sports jerseys. Yeah, everyone's saying it. Everyone's saying in the chat, 10K doesn't go anywhere. 6 grand B, the audio is king. That's sad. Audio is king. That soundbite kills me to this day. Till this day, as fucking Deontay Wilder is saying, that audio is king comment is just insane levels of copium. Audio is king. Really? Cool. Damn, that's like one purse for Mexico. Exactly, that's like one purse for the Mexican. No, he's a numbers guy. And that's why I said, because I personally think, I don't know if you guys agree, I don't know if do we have any sneakerheads in the chat? I've always had, my theory has always been, for any sneakerheads that are in the chat, my theory is this. I have a theory that most of Brendan's shoes are fake. And I know this because I'm a sneakerhead and I've bought some reps before, right? So I know what they look like. And I also know he doesn't have the ability to just be able to, I don't think so. So that's a funny and bittersweet thing about Brendan. He has to buy his wife legit bags, but then he has to buy his own shoes fake or reps. Of course, they're good level, but I think he buys reps because there's no way you can afford to buy limited edition shoes from resellers for the amount they charge and also buy your girlfriend or your wife Birkin bags. It doesn't exist. So that's a kind of bitter pill he has to swallow. Yeah, can I have to give his, provide a lifestyle for his kids? They go to fucking private school. His wife gets Lamborghini trucks and real bags, but then he has to, you know, resign himself to getting freebies and getting reps. Sad, but hey, that's the life he chose. Then we're gonna go on this, and then we're going to find the kid. I've got some notes here I want to talk about. This is a funny clip here as well. We're gonna find the kid sub. This is the.